Good evening. At the beginning of the celebration, we are going to receive the oils. So may we invite those carrying the oil to come forth with the oils.
Oil of the sick.
The oil of the sick has been blessed by the bishop for the healing of body, mind, and soul. May the sick who are anointed with it experience the healing and compassion of Christ and his saving love.
The oil of the catechumens.
This oil of catechumens has been blessed by our bishop for the anointing of those preparing for baptism. Through this anointing, they are strengthened by Christ to resist the power of Satan and reject evil in all its forms as they prepare for the saving waters of baptism.
The sacred chrism.
This holy chrism, a mixture of olive oil and perfume, has been consecrated by our bishop and the priest of our diocese. It will be used to anoint infants after baptism, those who are to be confirmed, bishops, priests at their ordination, and altars and churches at the time of their dedication.
The God of all gladness. Before his presence let us come with praise and thankful voice. Acclaim the Lord with grateful hearts. Oh, praise him and rejoice. Go up to the altar of God, the God of our gladness and joy. Raise up the cup of salvation and call on the name of the Lord.
Amen. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
With your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters, tonight we celebrate the Lord's Supper that Jesus instituted the Eucharist and the priesthood and the commandment of new love. For many times we have failed to appreciate this gift of God. We acknowledge our sins and ask for God's pardon and mercy. I confess,
Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, and what I have failed to do. Through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever virgin, to all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks. Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth.
Let us pray. O God, who have called us to participate in this most sacred supper, in which your only begotten Son, when about to hand himself over to death, entrusted to the church a sacrifice new for all eternity, and bequeathed to his love, grant, we pray, that we may draw from so great a mystery the fullness of charity of life, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, This month shall stand at the head of your calendar. You shall reckon it the first month of the year. Tell the whole community of Israel, on the 10th of this month, every one of your families must procure for itself a lamb, one apiece for each household. If a family is too small for a whole lamb, it shall join the nearest household in procuring one, and shall share in the lamb in proportion to the number of persons who partake of it. The lamb must be a year old male and without blemish. You may take it from either the sheep or the goats. You shall keep it until the 14th day of this month, and then, with the whole assembly of Israel present, it shall be slaughtered during the evening twilight. They shall take some of its blood and apply it to the two doorposts and the lintel of every house in which they partake of the lamb. That same night they shall eat its roasted flesh with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. This is how you are to eat it: with your loins girt, sandals on your feet, and your staff in your hand. You shall eat it like those who are in flight. It is the Passover of the Lord. For on this same night I will go through Egypt, striking down every firstborn in the land, both man and beast, and executing judgment on all the gods of Egypt. I, the Lord. But the blood will mark the houses where you are. Seeing the blood, I will pass over you. Thus, when I strike the land of Egypt, no destructive blow will come upon you. This day shall be a memorial feast for you, which all your generations shall celebrate with pilgrimage to the Lord as a perpetual institution. This is the word of the Lord.
Communion with the blood of Christ. Our blessing cup is the communion with the blood of Christ.
How shall I make a return to I will take up.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I received from the Lord what I also handed on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night he was handed over, took bread, and after he had given thanks, broke it and said, "This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, also, the cup after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the death of the Lord until he comes." The word of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. I give you a new commandment, says the Lord. Love one another as I have loved you. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Before the feast of Passover, Jesus knew that his hour has come to pass from this world to the Father. He loved his own in the world, and he loved them to the end. The devil had already induced Judas, son of Simon the Iscariot, to hand him over. So during supper, fully aware that the Father had put everything into his power and that he had come from God and was returning to him, Jesus rose from supper and took off his outer garments. He took a towel and tie it around his waist. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and dry them with a towel around his waist. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Master, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered and said to him, "What I am doing you do not understand now, but you understand later." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus answered him, "Unless I wash you, you have no inheritance with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Master, then not only my feet, but my hands and head as well." Jesus said to him, "Whoever has bathed has no need except to have his feet washed, for he is clean all over. So you are clean, but not all." For he knew who would betray him. For this reason, he said, "Not all of you are clean." So when he had washed their feet and put his garment back, he reclined at table again. He said to them, "Do you realize what I have done for you? You call me teacher and master, and rightly so, for indeed I am. If I, therefore, the master and teacher, have washed your feet, you ought to wash the other's feet. I have given you a model to follow, so that as I have done for you, you should do also." The Gospel of the Lord. Today is Holy Thursday, which we celebrate the Last Supper. We call it the Last Supper. We also call it the Lord's Supper. The Last Supper because it was the last meal of Jesus with his disciples. The last time he ate with them. It was his last Passover with them. After he had eaten with them, he went to the garden to pray. He was arrested, and the rest of the story followed. It is the Lord's Supper because this gathering was very important, very special for Jesus and his disciples. Jesus had been teaching about so many things, but he seemed to put everything so concretely at this time. So we say the Lord's Supper, by which he reveals so many things to them. When we celebrate tonight, we celebrate about three important components of our Catholic faith, expressed in the teaching, statements, and actions of Jesus. We learn from the Gospel, Jesus bringing the disciples together, washing their feet. So by this, when Jesus finished washing their feet, he gave a very important statement to the disciples by telling them that you should love one another as I have loved you. So as we celebrate the washing of the feet, we are celebrating the love and kindness and goodness of Jesus to his disciples and to all of us. And in the teaching of Jesus, when at one point in time somebody came to ask him, a lawyer, what is the greatest of the commandments, the response of Jesus to him was that you must love God above all, and you must love your neighbor as yourself. So the foundation of Jesus' teaching is about love. And in today's celebration, Jesus is expressing to us what it means to love, to serve the other person, to do good to the other person, to humble yourself, to help the needs of others. This is what Jesus did, and this is what he is teaching us, his disciples, to do. Jesus is teaching us another lesson. Today we celebrate also the institution of the priesthood. Jesus, for the 3 years, had been going round with the disciples, following him, Jesus teaching them, training them to take over from him. He knew he was not going to be in this world forever. So he prepared them for the task he was entrusting to them. So when they have followed Jesus and had come to know what Jesus was doing, the mission of Jesus to establish and build the kingdom of God, Jesus left everything to them to continue with it. So where Jesus ended, they continue from there. So Jesus being the priest, he has transferred to them, his disciples, and to us, the priesthood of Christ, the institution of new priesthood. There used to be a priesthood before Jesus, the priesthood of the Jews, but here Jesus has come to transform it, to make it new, to make the priesthood a service to the kingdom of God. It's meant to serve the children of the kingdom of God. That is the new priesthood Jesus is living to us. In the old priesthood, you become a priest by inheritance, by coming from a particular family. But the new priesthood of Jesus is from all over the world, all nations of all languages being called to follow Jesus. And as people of faith, as Christians, as children of God, we all share also in this priesthood of Christ at different levels. And so we are all called to humble ourselves, to serve the people of God, to serve the kingdom of God, and to help to build this kingdom by the love Jesus is living to us. Today we also celebrate the new Passover, the institution of the new Passover. Passover was the feast of the Jews, which reminds them of their liberation from Egypt, from the slavery of Egypt. So on the night by which they were saved, they were asked to slaughter lambs, mark their doorposts with the blood of the lamb, so that the angel of destruction will not enter into the homes of the Jews to kill their firstborn. And this became an annual celebration of the Jews all the time. And Jesus himself was celebrating it. On Sunday, we heard a reading. Tomorrow, we are going to hear again where Jesus even sent his disciples to go to a particular town to look for somebody to prepare the Passover feast. And by celebrating the Passover, Jesus made it new. The celebration of the old Passover by the Jews was a slaughter of lambs, a celebration, a sacrifice of blood. But Jesus has come to transform it by offering his life to die on the cross for the salvation of all of us, for the salvation of the world. And so as Jesus gathered together with his disciples, bringing them together, he took the bread and said to them, "This is my body." And he took the wine, gave it to them and said, "This is my blood," which we celebrate all the time, the new Passover, the Eucharist, which we celebrate on the altar of Christ. But this time, not a bloody sacrifice, but a sacrifice of faith in Jesus, who has offered himself to us in the bread and wine as his body and blood to share the salvation he's bringing to the whole world. So on this day, this Holy Thursday night, when we celebrate the Lord's Supper, we celebrate very important component of our Christian faith. We celebrate the call to all of us to love God, to love one another. We celebrate the cause to render our life in service for others. We celebrate to offer our life by following the example of Jesus as a sacrifice for the good of the world, for the growing of the kingdom of God. So as we celebrate this tonight, may we pray and ask God that by sharing this mission of Christ, we come to build his kingdom among all people so that all come to share the salvation. Like the celebration of the Jews, the Passover of the Jews, it was meant to remind them of their salvation from being attacked, being killed, or being destroyed by the angel of destruction. But they were saved, and therefore they reminded themselves of it. And so it is also for us. The death of Jesus on the cross for us is our salvation. It is the salvation of the whole world. And therefore, as we celebrate this occasion, we express gratitude and thanks to God for his goodness to us and ask him for his grace to respond to his goodness so that we live our life as true disciples of Jesus and come to share his kingdom when we are called into it. So we may now invite those who have been selected for the washing of feet. Let us all rise as we bring our prayers to the Lord. Dear friends, trusting in God's goodness to us, we bring our petitions to Him.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For Pope Francis, Bishop Barr, and all priests who today celebrate the institution of the priesthood and renew their promises to serve God and His people, we pray to the Lord. For all government leaders, that the Holy Spirit inspire them and give them the grace to act as humble servants, setting the example of service for others, we pray to the Lord. For an increase in vocations to the priesthood and the religious life, and for young men and women to remain open to the call to enter the service of God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all victims of violence, terrorism, and war, that God may look graciously upon their needs and bring them relief and peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in our parish and throughout the world who will be baptized and confirmed at the Easter Vigil, that they will always remain close to Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the people of St. Joseph Parish, that through the observance of these holy days, we may unite ourselves more closely to Christ in His passion and cross, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the sick in body, mind, or spirit, especially Sue Benjes and Anthony DePippo, that they experience the healing of Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, especially the construction workers who perished in the Francis Scott Key Bridge collapse, that their hope in eternal life may be fulfilled, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear.
For all the intentions in our book of prayer and for those we offer now in silence. And in a special way, we pray for all of our parishioners for whom this Mass is being offered. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Good and gracious God, look kindly upon us and listen to the prayer we offer to you in faith through Christ our Lord.
Ube kari heta sera mo Deus ibi est. Ube kati heta sera mo Deus ibi est. Congregari hito seru
Congregamos de nos mentes.
Let us pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, Almighty Father. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries, for whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the true and eternal priest who instituted the pattern of an everlasting sacrifice and was the first to offer himself as a saving victim, commanding us to make this offering as his memorial, as we eat his flesh and was sacrificed for us. We are made strong, and as we drink his blood that was poured out for us, we are washed clean. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are home, full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humbly pray and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, this offering, this holy and unblemished sacrifice, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, John, our Bishop, and all those who holding to the truth hang on the Catholic and Apostolic faith.
Remember, Lord, your servants and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you the sacrifice of praise, for they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true.
Celebrating the most sacred day on which our Lord Jesus Christ was handed over for our sake, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter, Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help.
Therefore, Lord, we pray graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which we make to you as we observe the day on which our Lord Jesus Christ handed on the mysteries of his body and blood for his disciples to celebrate. Order our days in your peace and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Through Christ our Lord, be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect, make it spiritual and acceptable so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer for the salvation of all today, he took bread in holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O Father, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more, giving you thanks, he said a blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servant and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gift that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gift of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who brought this participation in altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. Hope in your abundant mercies to us also, your servants, who through those in us, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon. Through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. 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 Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven,
deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. We live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the peace of Christ. Peace be with you. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you've taken away the sins of the
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. The body of Christ.
Amen.
Body of Christ. Body of Christ.
Bunnies
Let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, that just as we are renewed by the supper of your Son in this present age, so we may enjoy his banquet for all eternity, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
We're now going to start our procession. Father will incense the Blessed Sacrament. He will then take it and start to proceed down the aisle. People in the pews just fall in behind us as we come by. We will go out and into Travis Hall. This year, I promise you, we will not set off any alarms. We'll do our best. But please just sing along with us as we're coming and follow through just as everybody comes through.
It's unmuted. You're on. You're hot.
Ubi caritas et amor, ubi caritas Deus ibi et, ubi caritas et amor, ubi caritas Deus ibi es, ubi caritas et amor, ubi caritas Deus ibi es, ubi caritas et amor. Ubi caritas Deus ibi est, ubi caritas et amor, ubi caritas Deus ibi est, ubi caritas et amor, ubi caritas Deus ibi est, ubi caritas et amor, ubi caritas Deus ibi est, ubi caritas et amor, ubi caritas Deus ibi est, ubi caritas et amor, ubi caritas Deus ibi est, ubi caritas et amor, ubi caritas Deus ibi est, ubi caritas et amor, ubi caritas Deus ibi es, ubi caritas et amor, ubi caritas Deus ibi es, ubi caritas et amor, ubi caritas Deus ibi es, ubi caritas et amor, ubi caritas Deus ibi es, ubi caritas et amor, ubi caritas Deus ibi es, ubi caritas et amor, ubi caritas Deus ibi es, ubi caritas et amor, ubi caritas Deus ibi